What's up, guys, and welcome back. We are live streaming American Truck Simulator, and as you can see, I got my truck. Should be good to go. Get in the cab here. Alright. So we have the more modern, style of the Kenworth. The only difference is I don't have the huge cab and all that on it. Didn't figure there was a reason. So, what we're going to do right now is we're going to find a load that is going from where I am to somewhere else. Again, this is using the external contracts, which is through the World of Trucks website. And I don't know what we're going to do. Let's find something. God, that's a long ride. I don't think I've been to Reading, though. FedEx, Walmart, Tesla, construction equipment here. We've got more Walmart trucks. A lot more Walmart trucks. Let's just go with a big one. Why not? That's going to pay the most anyway. So, alright. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this here. So what we want to do first is we're going to take that trip, but we know we're going from Flagstaff to Reading. So what I'm going to do is tab out, and I'll show you guys. Let me just slip over to it. There we go. Alright, so we know what the cargo is. It's a reservoir tank. Okay, so reservoir. I can't spell today, but that is the goal. Reservoir tank. And we are going from Flagstaff to Reading. And then we leave this information blank. We'll know what time we start when we actually collect the job. So what we'll do is we'll snap back over to the game and get the job and find out what time it is once we get the trailer. There we go. All right, so we're going to go ahead and take that job. Looks like it's going to be a pretty easy job, not anything too strenuously terrible. And then from there, we'll grab a hold of the trailer and go. Okay, so this has it all pretty much set up for us. Make sure we got our lights on properly. Yep. Now, I'm not sure where this job is that we're actually picking it up. It could be right here. It could be 100 miles from here. I'm impressed. We got the green light. I swung that way too wide. We should be topped up on fuel, so we should be okay there. Gauge looks like it's pretty full, so we're gonna rock and roll. So it looks like there's our container ship right there to our right. So we'll have to pull in and grab that. So what I'm gonna do is throw my four-ways on. And I'm backing in here. Swing ourselves out so we can see. Now, a trick to backing into a trailer, you always want to try and get a visual sight back. It's an easier way to do it. Blindside backing is more of a pain in the ass. Pardon my French. And there it is. So we've got our trailer. First shot, that was actually pretty good. I'm happy with that. Alright, so now we're going to hit escape, and it gives us the time up here in the top right corner. It's going to be Monday at 4:22 a.m. So then what we're going to do is we will tab out. I will swap this over to the logbook page so you guys can see it. And we know that it is Monday. At 4:22 a.m. And then we'll have, when we get done, it'll tell us the time, and we can put how long it took us, which is in real time, not in game time. So there's that. It's pretty kind of a cool system. I like the little logbook thing. It really adds to the immersiveness of it. Then again, I may be crazy, and I could be totally wrong. I think it really adds to the appeal, but I could be crazy. I have been claimed to be crazy. Clear there. Make the swing out wide. Because we have to do a complete Louie in order to get out here. Looks like we're clear of the fence. I'm going real soft and easy. Yep. We're clear of the fence and we're on the road. Now, you guys are probably looking at my screen going, why in the world does he have it not full screen? If I play it in windowed mode, it plays fine. If I play it in full screen, it really messes it up. So I would rather not screw up my recording, and I'll just have it in full screen. Makes sense, right? Right. I could record the game picture itself, but then it causes more issues than what it's worth, and well, frankly, I just don't want to deal with that. It's a nice truck right there too. The older Kenworth. Should turn green for us here in just a minute. There it is. For fuel and distance, there we go. So what I just did there is I changed the information on the dash so that I can see how much fuel we have and how many gallons we currently have. Oh, this is a stop. How many gallons we currently have on top of what the distance is that we can travel. He ain't stopping. Neither is he. We're never gonna get out here. Here we go. We're going. And voila. So something cool that I did put together, guys, I do have a green screen behind me, and, oh, speeding. Are you fucking kidding me? Whatever. So I do have a green screen behind me. There we go. And I can pop that up and show you guys if you'd like. I think we actually have to take this exit. So what I'm gonna do is we'll get up here. Right here, I'll hit that. And then I will show you guys the camera. How about that? So the camera ain't super great, as you guys can see. I am working on trying to play with the settings to get it right, but it's taking some time just playing around with it, trying to get it to look proper. At the moment, the top of my head is not existent. But it is something I'm working on, trying to get things working properly the way they should be and whatnot. But it's still in testing stages, trying to get everything right. Once it's all right and everything's set up, we'll be good to go in Golden. I try not to run high beam. I see trucks do this on the highway all the time. They race each other side by side to see who's better. And it usually turns out that the guy that went on the outside wins. But it's really annoying when it's only a 2 or 3 lane highway and they got all of them blocked. Kind of puts the kibosh on things. And I'm honestly not pulling very far in front of them very fast. A little disappointing. Not that it matters, I'm on this highway for a while. But a little update for you guys. Rebelheart Gaming is coming into its own. We're gonna have a Signal 15, which is an affiliate with Rebelheart Gaming, which means Rebelheart Gaming plays on the server and they are whitelisted. However, it is open enrollment. Anyone can apply to be able to play on the server within the Signal 15 community. Which in turn, it's a community of people that like to play GTA 5 with mods and stuff online. It's using 5 Reborn, so it's not LSPDFR. It is SAPDFR, I guess. I don't really know what they'd call that. It's 5 Reborn instead of being Ragehook. It's running all off of Scripthook. I'll give you a definite on that when I know for sure. But it runs off a different system, so it's kind of cool. There's actually a lot of communities out there that do that. However, we do have some advantages to ours. One is you'll get to patrol and play with us. But two, we have a completely unique rank structure. We have completely different vehicles from other servers and stuff that I've seen, and we also, sorry, I thought I saw that car creeping up too quick, we also have added cars, which in turn means we have cars that are not spawnable through a trainer. You have to enter the code manually. As far as I'm aware, we're one of the only, or one of the two servers out there that know how to do that. Thanks to our fearless leader, Priest0802, he has added the ability to have that type of thing set up. And, oh, I need that exit. I chose the wrong day to take that exit. He figured out a way to be able to do that. So that's super cool. We had that ability. We also have some unique things like our light patterns and stuff like that. We have cars with red and blues, and we have cars with all blue. So that's pretty neat. We just updated to the 6.0 pack. Now the 6.0 pack, pretty much what it did was it changed a couple of pet skins. It changed a couple of little things here and there, but pretty much it's still the standard pack. But if you guys are interested in checking that out, that's really cool. That's a really cool thing. Head over to www.rebelheartgaming.com. once you're there, if you click on the forums, create a login, get approved, it'll show, you should see an application access page, and then on that application access page, you will be able to apply from there. Now, we also, in order to be able to approve, would like you to get on our TeamSpeak. So if you have TeamSpeak or use TeamSpeak, if you have a mic, that would be helpful. We would like to chat with you just to be able to, you know, communicate and whatnot. The one person that you want to get a hold of that's heading this whole thing up is Repo Studios. He usually is on there quite often. If he's not, you can message anyone on this on the website, and we will be able to, any board member, we will be able to get a message out to him as soon as we can and get him to be able to respond to you guys. If that is something that you are interested in doing, please, by all means, head over to the website, rebelheartgaming.com, and set up and apply there. We're not discriminatory. I believe the regulation is you have to be 13 due to ESRP ratings and stuff like that, and child command laws, stuff like, you know, certain laws my mind's not working right today. certain laws and regulations, there we go, state that we are required to make to get verification that they are of age of 13 or older. Now obviously the game itself is 17 or older. I don't think we're going to regulate to that, just because we want it to be open so that people can join and whatnot and play. But if that's something you're interested in, please let us know. Repo Studios has put a lot of work into the SOPs and stuff like that, which in turn stands for Standard Operating Procedure. So he has a lot of work put into that and whatnot, and it looks really good. So. But yeah, if you guys are definitely interested in something like that, by all means, head over to the website, sign up, get your application put in, check that out, or at least get signed up to where we can send you a message with our TeamSpeak information so that you can join us in chat. We would very much like to talk to you. We would like to talk to anyone, really, that is interested in it, just to feel them out, get an idea how they fit, that kind of thing. What else? I can't think of anything else. Recent news topics. The Gatlinburg wildfires, which is Gatlinburg, Tennessee, and the Kentucky wildfires have... I want to say they're starting to die down a little bit thanks to the rain and stuff that they've gotten. I haven't heard a news update as of today. What is this crazy whack job doing? I haven't heard a news update since today. However, yesterday, which would have been the 30th? The 1st? One of those 2 days. It was starting to die down. However, unfortunately, the death toll was up to 7, with several people still injured. My driving is terrible, by the way, FYI. They are currently investigating the fact that it's possible it could have been human caused, which means, you know, anything at this point. Somebody could have thrown a cigarette down and it lit up the sky or whatever. I mean, there's no definition on human cause. So it looks like that's starting to subside. I hope it's gonna get better. I mean, at this point it has to get better. But they have volunteer fire departments from all over, oh, that changed to red real quick. They have fire departments from all over the state. and out of states coming in to help with putting it out and that type of thing, which is really awesome. You know, when crisis happens, it's amazing what kind of people show up and come out of the woodwork. I think it's great that they have all these volunteers and people that are willing to come in and help with all these catastrophes and issues that everyone is going through and having here. Contrary to popular belief, a lot of the news information was saying that all of Gatlinburg and Pigeon Forge was destroyed. That is not accurate. At this current time, from what I understand, the aquarium in Pigeon Forge, or Gatlinburg, one of the two, I'm not sure exactly which side that's located on, but those two locations are the worst affected. However, the main strip in Pigeon Forge was not affected, and the aquarium is in fine condition. The animals are still fine, so that's cool. You know, that's great to hear. What else is going on in the news? President-elect Trump. I'm not. Now, let me throw this out there before I get too crazy. I'm not going to be biased towards one political party to the other. However, he has changed a couple of his. Or it sounds like he has changed a couple of his policies that he was big into when he was running. But I don't really know a whole lot about stuff like that, just because I don't pay attention to politics too much. I get bugged a lot by things that happen or things that are going on. Oh, I'm gonna block this intersection. I hate Vegas. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get through Vegas here, and then I'm going to find somewhere that I can pull off for a couple minutes, and we're going to take a short break. And when we come back, we'll try and finish off this load to Reading. I'm already committed. This is sending me right through the heart of Vegas, too. Okay, awesome. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull right over here. Alright. We're going to pull over here. I have my four ways on, so they'll go around, which is really nice. Cool little thing they've put into this. And I will be back here in just a second. Like I said, I'm going to take a short little break, and we will return.
Microphone activated.
Microphone muted.
Okay guys, we're back. So before I get started here, I want to test out the camera. So I was really cold actually, so I went and put a sweatshirt on, and now we're going to test out the camera and see how it looks. And there it is. It don't look terrible. I mean, it's semi-see-through. It does have a small square edge on it, but I mean, it is what it is. So we'll get the truck started up. We got air. Put it in gear and we're going. And we're in an only lane. So we're gonna get ourselves out of the only lane here. Not too bad. Something's really laggy with it though, and I don't know why. It's like I can only stream for a certain amount of time, and then after that it just becomes a lag fest, and no matter what game I'm playing. But yeah, this is sending me all the way through Vegas. I think it's my camera that's causing this much lag, to be totally honest. Yeah, that's some pretty bad lag. We might have to swap it back from camera. Do that real quick. Bink. Before we wind up in a wall. There we go. Yeah, see, and now the lag stops. So I think my camera is causing some lag. And there's not a whole lot I can do right now to fix that. Mostly, I just need to get out of this city. My car let me move in. Oh my god. I'm trying to pay attention to my lights and I'm not paying attention to where I need to be going. You have to stop, idiot. God, people are dumb. Okay. This is going to be a long trip. We stay on this road for quite a while. So if there's anything you guys want to talk about, please leave it in the comment section below or something like that. And I'll gladly chat about that in the next recording or live stream, depending on what we do. More than likely it'll be a live stream. I haven't been doing a whole lot of live streaming and stuff, mostly because the job I have requires me to work all night, so I don't get to live stream a whole lot because I wind up sleeping all day. So, I mean, I would love to have live streaming and stuff become a permanent job for me, but, I mean, let's face it, that happens to very few people, and I really don't think I'm going to be one of those people. We're not taking any variations, we're just staying right here. You idiot. We're about to hit 500 miles on this truck, which is really cool. Now granted, that's nothing, but 500 miles is pretty good. And I give you guys a full-size look of the truck and everything. I think it looks pretty good. Personal opinion. We just stop on a dime for no reason. The hell are you doing, Domino's? You notice their truck? Oh my god, I'm chopped liver. Notice that their trucks' logos match the truck trailer. That's pretty cool. Little workshop add-on that's through Steam. I've got to get across both highways. This is the worst section to get on. Here we go. That worked. Yeah, that's the worst area to get onto. Kind of surprised we didn't wreck it. And he's gonna pull out in front of me. Chopped liver, telling you. I'm about ready to race a big brown truck and win. Well, maybe not, he's pulling away from me. So one of my favorite pastimes to do is when I'm, I don't know, bored? Bored's not the word I want to say. When I'm in a mood where I just don't want to record, I don't want to do anything or be anywhere, I just get my car. I drive a Jeep, but I get my vehicle and I just start driving. And wherever I wind up, I wind up. I don't really pay attention. I don't stop anywhere per se. I just drive. It's relaxing for me. I find it really calming. And so when I get in this and it's like, I don't find this very calming. The people are irritating. It's kind of like real life. I mean, the drivers are dumb. They're slightly irritating. They cut you off. It's exactly like real life. I just had an epiphany. But yeah, I have noticed, oh, I only got 900 miles left on my tank. Hope we have a fuel station before then. We should. I mean, Jesus, 900 miles. Should have a fuel station before then. We'll reassess once we get there. Really, we shouldn't have. Oh god. That's wrong. So wrong. I goofed. We shouldn't have very much further. It says 8 hours, 322 miles. So, another 5 minutes, maybe ish, or so. About 5 or 10 minutes. Might be even less than that. But I don't think we're in California yet. Maybe we are. I haven't really been paying attention. Usually when you hit California, the scenery changes. Like you go from deserty to a lot more green. I haven't seen that yet. Which in turn tells me we are still in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. Yep, we gotta get up through Reno before. Once we go through Reno, then we've gotten into California. Now we're getting there. We're definitely getting there. Thank you. Yo, Spear Tip, what's up, buddy? What is going on? What is this guy doing? Lost all my speed. I need speed for hills. Rockstar Game, hit the follow button. Thank you, Rockstar. Appreciate that. Other two are sleeping and I'm tired. Well, go to bed, man. If you stick around till I get this load delivered, you can get an idea of what I've been working on for the live stream. Saw my feed in your email? Yeah. Because you have it set up so Twitch emails you whenever somebody goes live. Give you an idea what I'm hauling here. I have a reservoir tank. Yay! Does the YouTube live stream look as good because the HID lights? High beam? I pretty much can't upgrade this any more than it is. Oh, this is gonna be a long ride. Makes it easier to watch. As far as quality of image, I think it's more or less the same. Well, that's good. That means it's actually working properly. I'm using a program called Restream, and it pretty much like feeds it to three different ones. It's on Hitbox, on YouTube, and on Twitch. So I'm live streaming on all three right now. And then the chat that I have, the program I have installed for the chat, shows all three chats in one program. It's kind of cool. But yeah, something I've been working on the live stream for. Awesome. Yeah, I had the chat disabled on YouTube. But yeah, oh, I have to go here. Well, we're not gonna make it. I'll have to go find a place to turn around. Something I've been working on for the YouTube is for the live stream, for this game, is I have a logbook that is, it's not linked with the game, but I have to enter in everything manually. But it keeps track of all the loads and stuff I've done. Why are we... I'm gonna do a UE right here. Should be able to get it around. Just like that. Alright. My delivery point's actually right here. Give me just a second. I'll get it to where we can get it there, get it parked, and I'll show you the logbook idea. Because I think it actually adds to the immersion of the game. He's batting down. Yeah. Alright, we're just gonna park forward, it don't matter. Alright. So with this one I can just pull in. They wanted me to swing around, back up, do all that. I'm just gonna pull in. Makes it easier. I'm gonna show you auto truck real quick. There it is. And synchronizing. Done. Okay, so World of Trucks completed 57 minutes. So here's something that I have set up, and this is really cool. The way I do it is I'll tab out, I'll swap over to logbook. There's just a trailer drop for that one. Yeah, I could have backed into somewhere, but either way, that plant itself is a trailer drop. Okay, so the information that we have, it took 57 minutes and we went from Flagstaff, Arizona to Redding, California. We hauled a reservoir tank, and to get the time done we have to go back into game for a hair of a second, and it's Monday at 10:31 p.m. So Monday 10:31 p.m. there. So that log is done. Now when I go and pick up another trailer, I'll fill in the information and leave this and this blank until the trip's done to keep it up to date. I think that's pretty cool. And then what I'm going to do here, I'll delete it, or I'll add something different, like my log will only be this long. But I got to remember how to do all that. It's been a while. There's a way you can go in and freeze your cells so it doesn't move. I just don't remember how to do it offhand. It's been a while. But yeah. And then what you do is you just flip back over to game. Well, I appreciate you stopping by, man. Yeah, definitely get some sleep. Thanks, dude. Yeah, have a good night, bud. Alright, let's find another job. Hopefully a short one. I don't want to do a super long one. I don't think I've been to Hornbrook, so anything going to Hornbrook would be awesome. that was the wrong choice to go with. There we go. Okay. There we go. There's one going to Harnbrook. So I'm just going to modify the stuff right here. Reading to Harnbrook diesel. All right, so we got diesel from Reading to Harnbrook, and we'll get the current time and stuff once we hook up the trailer. I bet the trailer's right here. There it is, right there. And the current time is Monday at 10:36. So, come over here. Monday, 10:36. Alright. Back to game and start. And this is going to Harnbrook. I've never been to Harnbrook, so this will be fun. And that's a very large trailer to tow around. This is a full 50-footer. Or, I'm sorry, a full 53 feet. There we go. And this is probably going to be the last trip I do today. So, just keep that in mind. Anybody who's watching, I appreciate you guys watching. That's awesome. Rockstar Gamer, you hit that follow button. I appreciate that. It's a large line of traffic. We just happened to hit a green light. So the exit right here to McCoy is closed, or McClay, not sure which. So we know he can't take that exit. I would play with my camera and stuff activated, guys, but unfortunately I can't due to the fact that it really messes up the game. It makes it super laggy. Anything that is run with OpenGL, which is this, is really laggy with cameras. And I have my high beam on so that it's not so dark for you guys. Which, he's got me for speeding. Whatever. Oh, great. Construction. Yeah, so I'm probably going to make this my final load for the night. It's also my last night off of work. I had a nice little 3-day vacation. And time to go back to the grindstone tomorrow. Now, granted, it's not until tomorrow night, being that I work 11 to 7 Eastern. But yeah, I'll have to get back into the grindstone of working. Gotta be able to afford to buy new games. But I do want to appreciate, I do appreciate you guys sticking around and watching and enjoying the stream. If there's something else that you guys would want to see or something like that, let me know. I'm up to change it up and do different stuff. I can get back into Rocket League. We're looking pretty close at possibly doing a throwback recording, throwback video, and doing some GTA 4 patrols, being that they've got the patch and stuff fixed and we're working on doing stuff like that. So it's a possibility we could be starting to do that, which would be really, really cool. Because I don't know if most of you know this, but I started doing LCPDFR on GTA 4, a modification that allows you to be a police officer while playing Grand Theft Auto, either single player or online. And that's kind of where I started recording and started live streaming, and mostly recording to start with. But that's where I started doing a lot of this stuff, and so the fact that they've made it more stable, they've made it accessible to be able to do things, more things on, it's kind of cool. It really, really makes me want to go back and play it just for the nostalgic of it. I mean, mostly just because this channel, this live stream, this recording sessions, they've come a long way since they first started. When they first started, my recordings and stuff were horrible. They were absolutely atrocious. I'm going here? Alright. Oh yeah. So I am. Apparently they want me to back in. Okay. So yeah, I mean, it's come a long way since when I first started. So it would be nice to be able to get back into that. Even if it was just for one or two shows, it would be really cool. Yeah, I cranked the wheels the wrong direction. Oh, but they'll take it. Alright, so let's get the data here. It took me 21 minutes. So we'll swap to 21 minutes logbook. And I'm just going to keep the logbook up for now just to show you guys. It was a 21 minute travel. And total time, the current date in game. There we go. Current date in game is Tuesday at 1:10 a.m. So then we can come here and go. What? Okay. Tuesday at 1:10. So yeah, that's pretty neat. And then, so there's that, and then we'll go back to here. Go back to drive. fill up the tank. We were down quite a ways. There it is. And that's it. We're parked. So, yeah, there we go. So I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. And we will have more live streams coming real soon. Hopefully soon. But this is the camera that I was telling you guys about. If I play a game with it, the game gets real laggy for some reason. I don't know why, but I do have the green screen. It's kind of cool. If I take that away, there we go. So yeah, the green screen's kind of cool, whatnot, but it's taking some time to adjust. I've got some things right and some things very, very wrong. So it's just a matter of playing with it and getting it to look right. Actually, that one, that just about did it right there. Yeah, that's not bad. So yeah, I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for a lot more live streaming coming soon.